Welcome, this is the Denouement Crew, where we analyze narrative storytelling in video games. I am your host, Arsenal, joined by Marley and Hunter. Why did I pause there? You're the hated one, congratulations.
Damn it.
Roll.
So, Dead Space, a little bit of background, is made in 2008. At the same time as that, Gears of War 2 came out, Fallout 3, Super Smash Bros. Brawl, and Far Cry 2. So, it's a horror game, and it was inspired by, allegedly, Resident Evil 4 and Silent Hill. So that's the brief background of it. Your developers are the Rest in Peace Visceral Studios, and your publishers are, unfortunately, EA Studios, otherwise known as Electronic Arts. I'm really doing well, guys.
Doing
it's
great.
Only a first draft. It's fine.
Yeah, I don't care. Like, it's not professional. So, we'll start with you, Marley. What do you know of Dead Space?
There's honestly not a lot that I know about Dead Space. I've seen a couple pictures of it. I've seen a couple trailers, maybe a couple memes on the internet, but otherwise, I am completely new to Dead Space lore, Dead Space narrative. So I am actually looking forward to all this.
Gotcha. And Hunter, what is your background history with Dead Space?
It's kind of the same. I remember watching a couple of YouTube videos about the Dead Space gameplay forever ago, but I really don't remember much. But I am really curious to see how this is going to go now that I'm actually paying attention.
So, as for me, I've played this maybe 4 or 5 times. Including the, I think it was a week after the game released. I was too young to play it back then. That's not accurate at all. Probably maybe 2013, 2014. And still the art direction really blows me away, at least my opinion on that. So we have two people that are completely new to the series and one that has played this way too much. So, without further ado, are we ready?
Yeah.
No, but we're going to go into it anyway.
Oh.
Well.
Isaac, it's me. I wish I could talk to you. I'm sorry. I'm sorry about everything. I wish I could just talk to someone. It's all falling apart here. I can't believe what's happening. It's strange. Such a little thing.
How many times you watched that thing? Guess you really miss her. Don't worry, we're almost there. You'll be able to look her up once we're on board. Sounds like you do have a lot of catching up to do.
All right, everyone, we're here. Sinking our orbit now.
All this trouble over that chunk of rock.
Deep space mining is a lucrative business, Ms. Daniels. Aegis 7 is a gold mine, according to Prospector's reports. Cobalt, silicon, osmium. Now, where is she? There she is. We have visual contact.
So that's Ishimura. Impressive.
The USG Ishimura. Biggest planet cracker in her class. And it looks like they already popped the cork.
Why is it all dark? I don't see any running lights.
Corporal, take us in closer and hail them. And stay clear of that debris field. We're here to fix their ship, not the other way around.
USG Ishimura, this is the emergency maintenance team of the USG Kellyan responding to your distress call. Come in, Ishimura.
You're gonna need to boost the signal if our power's low.
Yes, we know. Boost the signal. More.
Never heard of a total communications blackout on one of these things. You'd think with 1,000 people on board, someone would pick up the phone.
What is that?
It's a busted array like we thought. Sounds like they're having problems with their encoder. You get us down there and Isaac and I can fix it. 48 hours max.
All right, you heard the lady. Take us in, let's see what needs fixing.
Gravity tethers engaged. Automatic docking procedures a go.
What the hell?
Sir, the auto dock.
What is it?
We're off track, we're gonna hit the hull.
Hit the blast shields. That guidance tether's damaged. Switch to manual, now.
Inside the magnetic field? Are you insane? Abort!
No, we can make it inside. Corporal, I gave you an order.
The field's too strong.
Is everyone okay?
What? What the hell were you thinking? Were you trying to get us killed?
I just saved our asses, Miss Daniels. If we had aborted at that speed and distance, we'd have smashed right into the side of the Ishimura. Now settle down, let's get to work. Corporal, report.
I'm not getting any readings from the port booster, and we've lost comms and autopilot. It'll take some time to
fix. All right, let's get some extra hands from flight deck to help out.
Hold still, Isaac. I'm syncing up everyone's rig with the ship. Okay, we're done. Clean bill of health for everyone.
All right. We've still got a job to do. We're moving out.
So yeah, I wouldn't say we're done with the intro quite yet. Maybe like 5 more minutes into that. But already, like, the art direction is, you know, it's its own thing. You have the health bar, like, right there instead of somewhere on the screen, like in the lower left-hand corner, as it usually would be.
I noticed that, and immediately I'm like, wow, that's a little different. You definitely see a lot more in a couple of other games that I've tried recently these days, but for the time that you mentioned that this came out, like, yeah, that's definitely a lot different.
It's impressive that they managed to pull this off for 2008.
I was going to ask, like, do they do this with, like, other people in the game as well? Like, is there...
Yeah, actually, right, that guy right there.
You didn't lose power to the port booster. You lost the port booster.
To the USG Unbelievable. Ishimura. The Ishimura was the first Planet Cracker class vessel, and is now the oldest serving, with 62 years of continuous service. It holds the record for highest number of planet cracks, with 34 to date.
Oh, God, what the hell?
That
guy just, like, he wants to fight.
Was that a Lenny face I saw in that screen there? Kind of looked like it, but...
I really like the way that they have the HUD in this game. It's not a HUD at all. It's like, I like the way they have, like, the HUD. It's like, a HUD, but it's the HUD.
Because this is a cry engine, right?
Is it the cry engine? I don't think.
It's Scream's cry engine, but I don't know.
I think it's Unreal, actually, like early Unreal Engine. I'd have to check on that, but I think maybe Crysis came out at the same time. I'd have to check.
Well, guess who has no life and a second monitor?
I have a second monitor as well.
That security console is still live. Isaac, log in and see what you can find. Kendra, get that elevator back online.
Power's dead. I can't.
Then reroute the damn power. Look, if we all cooperate, we can
figure it looks like he uses
computer display up, Isaac.
Software from Havoc.
Okay.
Huh. That doesn't look good. She's taken a lot of damage.
The tram system's offline.
That's a lot of damage.
That's a lot of damage.
Oh.
What the hell was that?
Automatic quarantine must have tripped when the filtration system restarted. Everybody relax.
What was that? Did you hear that?
I'm not sure.
What the hell?
I don't know. Something's in the room with us.
Jesus! Open fire! Open fire! Kendra, power! Kendra!
Come on. Come on. Got it!
Isaac, get the hell out of there!
The door's unlocked! Run! Run, Isaac! Get the hell out of there!
That made me jump a little bit, not gonna lie.
Why do I feel like this is gonna be one of those look up situations? Oh, nope, never mind. It's the door.
Oh no.
Occupied.
Occupado!
It's a Max Loadster. I'm very heavy.
Hands. He had a hunger that only foot. Hands could satisfy.
Limbs.
Foot that looks like hand.
This is Benson. Everybody listen up. They're using the vents. That's how they're getting around the ship. Stay away from Gal. Get back. Get back.
I don't know, engineer. Sounds kind of sus.
I think they're okay.
Isaac.
Oh yeah, I thought this was cool. Like, you can see them on the screen, but you could just be like, oh, hey.
We ran into more of them on the way over here. Are you okay?
More what? What the hell are those things? Is that the crew?
Keep your voice down. Whatever they are, they're not friendly, and half the doors on this ship are locked because of the quarantine. Now, we have to get to the bridge, but first, we gotta repair the tram system.
You're crazy, Hammond. You're gonna get us all killed.
If you listen to me, I will get you out of here alive. Now, what's wrong with the tram?
The data board is fried, but there should be a spare in the maintenance bay. There's also a broken tram blocking the tunnel that needs to be repaired. Damn it! Everything is on the other side of this quarantine. We can't reach it from here.
No, we can't. But you can. Isaac, if I can get to the bridge, I should be able to access the personnel files. You fix the tram, and I'll help you find Nicole.
So I'm already seeing some narrative cross-references here. Maybe not in terms of, like, gameplay, but in terms of, like, objective. The objective is always to get from where you are to the bridge or find a way to repair the tram. These are usually good approaches that keep things going for a long time because there are many different obstacles that you have to get to, maybe an engineering room to activate the tram. Or maybe something's blocking the elevator itself to get up to the bridge.
Mm-hmm.
So the pathway that I can see between this, like, obviously, like, I'm going super, super old school to, like, 94 with System Shock 2 in this reference.
Ooh.
And even with the original System Shock. So you obviously started in the med bay, and you had to find your way to the bridge, but there were some obstacles that you had to overcome, like straight down. You had to go down to engineering first, and then you had to go to hydroponics because there was no other. As you take the elevator up, there's a biomass that's keeping you from going to the bridge. So you have to clear everything in hydroponics. And then you can finally get to the command deck. And then from the command deck, you have to take a different lift to get you up to the bridge.
Gotcha. So it's pretty much like we have one step, but then we have extra steps after that.
Yeah, you have a goal. It's basically like Shrek. Farquaad gives Shrek another quest, and like, quest! I'm already on the quest!
So that's our second time we've been told to shoot limbs. This is unfortunately one of the problems with this game, is that it reminds you that, oh yeah, you need to do this to survive. Don't be a dumbass.
So is it kind of hand-holdy like Metro Last Light?
I didn't think you were going to reference that. A little bit, but it stops after that. It's like the one time that they're like, shoot the limbs.
Well, at least the companions don't do everything for you, so.
Yeah.
That is also probably, like, set as a reminder, because, like, the way that the whole intro of this started, you're probably not paying attention to it the first time.
Yeah, and probably for, like, every game that you've done in before this, you'd probably... Let's say, like, you know, we're back in, like, 2008. and we're thinking like, oh, go for the headshot. Oh, wait, I gotta aim for the limbs this time. So,
yeah, something your first instinct would be to shoot the head.
We also have a time machine.
No, no.
Not really. It's not a time machine. Please. It's just, oh, I can slow things down now. So.
That's fine.
Was the safe station picture a digital camera?
Yeah.
Why though?
I don't know. I've never asked that.
I mean, I'm kind of knocking against it because I'm trying to find the reference for it because I'm pretty sure it's connected to something, but like, either. It's very strange.
The old George Lucas.
Think of anything else.
The old George Lucas. Everything's connected. And it's poetry. It has to rhyme.
Listen up, car 8 is trashed. We managed to get it back to the repair depot, but now the auto load is destroyed. I need a stasis module brought down here now. Look at this piece of shit off the tracks. It's gonna jam up the whole system.
The audio log saying that's another big system shock thing as well.
Oh yeah?
I can't say that's actually where it originated, but it definitely had a connection there.
I feel like it adds to the lore and the history. Oh God!
You know where all the jump scares are. Clearly.
From the control room, faster the better. I can hear something crawling around out there.
Nah, but what's awesome about audio logs versus NPCs is that it adds the atmosphere that there's something wrong. Like there's no one else here. Except for, obviously, like, the dedicated people you're talking to and see on a video link. But you also learn more about people that are there.
Yeah, it makes the world... I love the when someone mentions that the world has to, have to revolve around you, not whatever the reverse is that, you know, you hit a trigger point and you see, like, a bunch of people running through a hallway. It doesn't really make the world feel alive if they're all just like trigger points that you have to reach somewhere. But if you, if it feels like they're interacting with each other, it feels like the world is alive. You know, immersive, as a lot of Skyrim players say.
But my immersion.
How do we feel about text logs? Do we want me to read them or nah? I don't think this one doesn't look important. It's just repair invoice, I guess.
Yeah, honestly, yeah. Well, it's like not like we're going into a deep dive of like, oh, we need to talk about the ships and how they interact with the narrative. Nah, we just need to talk about none of that. No, shame on you.
The purple man in Fries Desert Freddy means something, and I have the answers.
You leave him out of this.
Alright, so I think I have to... Oh. Yep, still there? Yep, okay.
I mean, where are they gonna go?
What was that, Hunter?
Where are they gonna go?
I think they set the bridge. Future me, play that clip.
If I can get to the bridge...
Strange. The quarantine just lifted.
Whatever was in the flight lounge must have left. That's lucky for us. Isaac, get back to the Kellion and prep it for launch. We'll find out what we can from the bridge and meet you there.
If we live that long, you're out of your league, Hammond. This is suicide. We're going to die out here.
Your lack of confidence in me is duly noted, Miss Daniels. But I have a mission to complete, and that's exactly what I am going to do, with or without you. Do we understand each other?
Just get us out of here alive.
Look at him. He's having a rave.
He's having a good time. Well, there he goes.
He's gonna end up like that Stormtrooper scene. He's gonna end up with 100 of them.
What was that?
I said this is gonna end up like that Stormtrooper scene from Star Wars where Han Solo is chasing down a Stormtrooper and there's like 100 of them.
Oh, yeah.
This is how Isaac dies.
This is how the... be an engine... Wow. How do I... Apparently I can't raise my foot over that.
You can't jump?
Yep.
You can't walk, but like, up.
Well then.
High quality graphics there. High quality.
Ten
physics.
Times the detail.
Hostile life form detected. Hull damage critical. Evacuate immediately.
How much manganese do we have on this ship?
Oh, I don't like the way they run.
I do not like the way they run.
What the hell is happening down there?
Really,
what happened to the ship
running, though?
That was our ride home. It's the only way off the ship.
Kendra.
No, Hammond! This changes everything!
Just let me think. Can you access the command computer?
It's no good. There's an executive lockdown of all primary systems. Without the captain's authorization, I can't access them.
Well, where's the captain?
Dead?
Here he is.
In dead space.
Captain Benjamin Mathias. Location? Med lab. Status? Deceased.
What? How?
I don't know. Look
I
around
can't
here.
Access that information. Find the captain, and you'll find his rig. With his authorization codes, I can crack this computer wide open.
Damn it. Isaac, I'm sending the tram back to your location. Get to the medical deck and find that rig as fast as you can.
What was that?
That was loud. Oh, I could use that. Get out of here. I haven't even been hit yet.
I'm such a pro at this game, I don't even need the small med packs. Turns around the corner, look, there's three bars.
I kinda know where everything is.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I'm gonna be slapped sideways by something simpler later and I'm gonna laugh.
You're so helpful.
This went from a narrative stream to just calling out Arsenal on his crap. On today's episode of Metroid.
Was it supposed to not have any audio?
It does not have audio in the first game.
That's very weird.
It is. So that's the first level. So I'd say that's pretty much the intro right there. So first impressions on this.
Where to start? I think as introductions go, it's pretty solid. I mean, most games nowadays, like, you don't see a lot of, like, origin stuff. Like, they throw you in the middle of it and they expect you to just pick it up and go, because you're just in a generation where things keep moving.
Mm-hmm.
This game is kind of a predecessor to that. Like, it does, like, give you a brief synopsis of, like, what's going on, where you are, and then they'll throw you into the middle of it, and then immediately there's chaos that ensues right after. And that's usually a good horror genre progression introduction for a game.
Absolutely.
Like this. So, that delivery was, for me, like, it made sense. It was all right. Well, it didn't really, like, wow me, but it was an intro. And most of the delivery was pretty on point.
Mm-hmm.
The voice acting to deliver the narrative, like, this is a very old game. Like, they didn't really care heavily on, like, dialogue or actually making things sound, like, the highest of quality, like, you would find in, like, a movie or when you're watching HBO at home.
He's here.
So listening back to that now,
that girl.
Oh yeah. So listening to that now, like it's kind of like nails on a chalkboard, but once you understand, like, it's an old game, it kind of makes sense. But for what it is, it still did a good job delivering it.
Yeah. Hunter, how you feel on first impressions?
I mean, I think it's pretty good as far as, like, intros go. I mean, I like it when games set up what's going on, especially when it comes to horror games. Because getting dropped in the middle of chaos just makes things really hard, especially when you have to purposely explore to find out specifically what's going on. This makes it really obvious what you're seeing.
Yeah, and to add on to that, we already have world building, the whole ships of the mining colonies, and we already know what Isaac's motivation is. He wants to find his girlfriend in all of this. Mm-hmm. So already we have he's a protagonist, so it's pretty impressive to already put a motivation on a speechless character. Now that's going to change with the remake in 2022. He's going to be voiced by the same guy for the second and third game. I don't know about the rest of the cast, but we'll see what that goes from there and how that changes from there.
It's weird that they're going to add a voice now that, like, he doesn't have any dialogue at all.
Yeah.
This is very interesting.
Yeah, they said on a live stream that he was going to comment on things that, quote-unquote, would be awkward if he didn't comment on it. And I don't know what... I have an idea of what they mean by that, but I don't know what they mean by it for what they're going to toss in. Because there could be a couple moments where if he just goes, ah, shit, then it's just like, did that really need to be there?
I mean, it does help, like, fill the game out a little bit more to feel like the character's actually a person and not just a lifeless robot that you're piloting.
Right.
Like, I like it when there's, like, small comments that people will make when shit jumps out at them, because it's like, yeah, that's actually startling.
Maybe not all the time, but...
Not all the time,
every
but...
once in a while.
Like, yes. Scripted things, like, when things pop out of the walls, like, in the that first part.
Right. It's always based on, like, execution. I know a lot of people seem to forget that word, is that when you have the premise of, like, oh, it's a ship with a bunch of monsters on it. I mean, obviously you could do zombies. That's a pretty popular one, but I don't think we can call necromorphs zombies. They're probably more like animated monstrosities, not really zombies. I guess you could make the argument that they are, but if they have like claws on their backs that are almost like knives, then that's probably not going to be the case when they have more than four limbs.
I would call them mutants.
Yeah, I would go with that too.
I mean, I don't know the whole lore behind them, but I have a feeling like they're old crew members and they were mutated.
Oh, yeah, we're 38 minutes into it, but we'll definitely learn more based on further. It doesn't answer every question, I'll say that now, but you get a pretty much good idea of like where they come from and how they even got here. So
good to know.
We shall continue.
Nothing to be afraid of. I knew you would come, just like you said. I saved this.
I can see, said the white blind woman to the deaf man.
Can I go now?
Use kinesis to move or throw objects.
To take me. Just shut up.
That never gets old.
What the heck kind of it, like, animation?
Like I said, the physics engine cannot handle a couple things. Anyway.
Like, that could have been a very tragic, like, death.
Okay.
And then you just shoot her arm off.
Okay, I guess.
That could have been a moment, but you ruined it even more than it already was.
You will not appear in the sequel.
Nope. She'll show up at the beginning of the next game going, remember me, like throwing her broken her like shot off our limb at you.
Dead Space 4.
Isaac, are you there? We were attacked.
Kendra's gone. 1 minute she was there, and I can't believe I lost her. We can still do this. Get me the captain's rig codes, and we'll find Nicole. Looks like the crew barricaded the door to the emergency wing. We have to blow through it to get to the morgue. Get some thermite from medical storage, and a shock pad from zero-G therapy. Should be down the corridor. Communication is useless in all this static.
Honestly, like, from this, the way the start was, like, they are, she was already, it was already a pro, like, an argument over authority. Because she kept making comments, and he was like, oh yeah, I know, and like, it was, they've been fighting this whole time.
Alright.
Mommy and Daddy are fighting again, please stop.
Yeah, it's a typical situation of there's already infighting, and it's like, how are y'all going to survive if you could barely stop fighting for 5 minutes?
I feel like that's a trope in a lot of horror movies.
Oh, it is! That's the sad thing.
100, yep.
If the game proves me wrong, by all means, but at this point in time, it's not.
I should probably ask, is how do we feel on third person and first person?
I don't really have a pull towards either. I don't feel like first person would ruin a character that's already established.
Okay.
Like, that does voicing-wise. But I've also played games that have done both really well.
Such as?
Fucking... I have to look through my list. Like, Cyberpunk? I know you haven't played it. But, like, you're... The character is an established character, even though you are playing them. And it's a first-person game throughout the entire time.
True,
and you talk the whole time. Yeah, like, so I don't feel like it really ruins anything.
Okay.
It just depends on the delivery and approach for me. Like, I've seen first-person games that have fantastic audio and voiceover dialogue, main protagonist talking. Like, Cyberpunk is a very strong example of that. But I've also had... This is just me, but I know that, like, if you look into something like 007 in, like, the early ages, like, before GoldenEye, like, Agent Under Fire, like, it doesn't really fit because, like, you know you're playing James Bond, but there are just some voiceovers that James Bond says that just don't really line up. But, and it also doesn't help that on top of that, you're getting cinematography after that where you actually see James Bond and you're not actually experiencing everything through his eyes, so it kind of throws off the entire thing. It's just like you're on some clips and then you watch a movie and then you're on some clips.
Gotcha.
Third person is one of those situations where it leans better for a silent protagonist. Like, my best example here is like early generation Warframe, like open beta Warframe. Like, the Tenno didn't talk at all. All the information came from the Lotus. But they've been evolving into more and more of an A-rated game. And they've been starting to introduce, like, new character stuff. Like, they actually do have a new character creator in, like, the later variants of the actual game.
Yeah, so, and I mean, they introduced the, I can't remember what they call it, but, I guess they're, I don't want to say they're children, but they're, like, able to mind control them, I guess?
That's something like that. I'm still trying to get through Warframe, but I'm always on and off.
Same. I lost my count, and I just stopped being interested.
Yeah.
I played Warframe, and it's very, very early days. Like, back when, you know, like, your intro was a big white, like, a big white zone. And now it's, like, this big open world. It's nuts.
I finally convinced Jurgens to show me the video feed from the colony. And what I saw was glorious. Breathtaking. Miners undergoing a transformation into something extraordinary. I must know more. Even as the believer within me wants to become one of them, the scientist needs to uncover their secrets. I need to study one of these necromorphs, as Kine so clinically puts it. I need to witness this infection firsthand. Perhaps that patient from the colony.
Nah, here we go.
Yeah.
This is like a small nitpick thing towards EA. What is it with their, like, EA's developers and using Maker or something close to Maker as a god?
I guess I don't follow. Are you Are you
referring like referring to Dragon Age, where the Maker was the name of the, that was what they called the god, and you know Mass Effect, where they also said Maker, and now it's Marker, just 2-letter difference from Maker.
You know, Mark and Mike.
Like, what is this?
Don't worry about it. I didn't even think about that. That's stupid.
Like, it's a really dumb thing for me to notice, but now I'm concerned.
So to explain what I was talking about earlier, that audio log with the guy that was very evil, conniving, is like, I must learn more. I must learn more. Basically, yeah. My comment was like, he's basically the Edward Diego or the Kerenchkin.
Mm-hmm.
So basically, like, they're not the main antagonist, but they are a very, very big reason why everything is as it is now. And you can tell that from the get-go.
The catalyst of the situation.
Basically, yeah.
Remember Hunter? Catalyst? You know, since we're on the Bioware thing, you know the catalyst?
You found something down there, didn't you?
Yes, we found something.
So the tanks were right all this time. I won't be certain of that. There was nothing divine in what I saw.
When Arsenal plays Dead Space, medium.
You sure about that?
I'm not so sure anymore.
Jesus Christ, I forgot that was there!
Oh god!
Another one to the counter!
Where'd your health bar go?
I know, I almost died! Okay, time to blow this up. Okay, I guess I won't back up.
Listen, I know you've got plot armor, but I'm pretty sure that plot armor should not be powerful enough to be at point-blank range with thermite.
Remember, the codes are on the captain's body.
Don't worry about it.
Yeah.
This is Senior Medical Officer Nicole Brennan transmitting ship-wide. We need more help. We don't have the resources to deal with this many cases. Nobody would tell us what's happening! These wounds. We are not equipped to deal with this. God! Get him to the table! Hold him! Nurse, you hold him down! Christ! Every corner.
That was Nicole, right? I can't tell from here when that log was made. I'm sure she's around here somewhere.
Somewhere mangled. I love seeing those guns that have like that rotation mechanic. It's really cool.
Yeah, and you know, the funny thing that people often forget is that this is just engineering equipment. Like, this apparently can blow off your limbs.
Engineering tools are no joke.
Yeah.
This is definitely not OSHA approved. OSHA is the party pooper that would just look you dead in the eye and go like, no, Patrick, mayonnaise is not an instrument.
Yeah.
Horseradish isn't either. No, oh, damn it, I was gonna ask if you could blow her head off, but she got plexiglass protecting her. Oh.
I did it with a mind trick.
Yeah. Don't worry, she did it for you.
Jedi Arsenal.
Hey, Captain.
Sir? Sir!
Oh.
Are you okay?
I think he's okay.
That doesn't look okay. Oh dear.
Oh my god, look at those ragdoll physics. Fucking delicious. Oh.
Oh my god.
I say we stop addressing that and address what the hell Marley just said.
I don't think anything needs to be said. I think that just needs to stay in.
I was trying to pay attention to, like, they're getting the right reactions. Wait, what is he saying?
I'll start accessing the captain's records right now. Enter a translation and I'll contact
him. Hi, I'm the funny enunciator.
Isaac,
Somehow one of them found a way down to the captain's nest. I managed to contain it in a damaged escape pod. Lifting executive lockdown now. I found the deck logs. Whatever is happening around here, it came from the planet when they cracked it open. It spread to the colony and reached the ship. Isaac, this isn't an infection. It's some form of alien life. Shit, we've got bigger problems. The ship's engines are offline and our orbit is decaying. Get over to the engineering deck ASAP while I stay here and figure out what the problem is.
Alright, to actually get back into a kind of serious map now. Compared from the introduction where there's multiple characters having voice acting lines,
mm-hmm.
compared to like now when it's just like one-on-one, it's a lot stronger. Like, a good comparison that I'm going to have this, and I hope I don't get a lot of flack out of this, is Xenoblade Chronicles 2.
Xenoblade...
You can tell.
Oh, I think I know where you're going with this.
Yeah, you can tell, like, the voice actors were clearly not in the same room when they were enunciating their lines.
Mm-hmm.
Nor did they get any context of where they are in the actual world. Or the situation that they have.
Yeah, I constantly wish that voice actors would do that in the same room. Like, it opens up a lot of just potential performance out of it. I think for the Arkham series, Mark Hamill and Kevin Conroy are often in the same room.
Mm-hmm.
But, I mean, they've been doing it for God knows how many years, for being Joker and Batman.
I mean, just certainly it's hard to get any kind of, like, feelings across voice acting when you're speaking to another person if you're not actually next to them. Mm-hmm. It's just like you're talking to just a piece of paper.
Yeah.
Personal log. Carrying a franchise chief about engineer yourself. Jacob Temple. It's been 2 days since they pulled that planet open, since the captain died. The panic, the riots, they were nothing compared with what came after. Our friends, our co-workers started coming back. Changed. Coming back to kill us, drag us away. Rucker disappeared this morning, and I have to assume he's dead. My crew, they're starting to crack. I'm trying to keep an eye on them, but right now I have bigger problems. We're hemorrhaging fuel, and the primary engine is laboring. Danvers and I are going to try to reach the fuel depot to see if we can fix it. Temple out.
You were saying, Marley?
What was I saying?
I don't know.
I can't remember.
All right, well, moving on.
I'm great at this.
Hey, it's fine. It's whatever.
Hello.
Hello there. I am here to guide you on your journey. I have to hit the console there. I was going to drop him for a second.
I thought you were trying to sit him on the bar.
Excuse me. Can I talk to you about our Lord and Savior, Isaac Clark?
Keep your hands and feet in the vehicle at all times.
Yzma, put your hands in there.
Oh, wait.
Oh.
I didn't realize you were on that kind of one.
That just sounded like a bunch of monsters anyway. Good luck with that. See ya.
What?
All right. So here's an interesting question.
Okay.
Limited or scarce ammo? Do you feel like that's more of a plot device or a game mechanic?
For strictly the horror genre?
Not just for the horror genre, but just in general.
I would say if they don't pick up, like, let's say they go into, well, I guess would we say, like, in a survivor situation, or are we saying, like, in war times?
No, that's a good point. I would say in this question, given where we are right now, we'll call it a survivor situation.
Okay. I would definitely find it concerning if, say, like, there was a military weapon, and it's not, you know, just the engineering, because this is just strictly a mining colony. I would find it a little strange that there's mostly military ammo. I'd probably consider it a plot contrivance just for the sake of gameplay. if it were, if, well, since it's just a mining colony, I would say that if there's a bunch of engineering ammunition for it, then I suppose it makes sense. But for like the flamethrower, it's probably a little too much.
I can agree with that.
Refueling sequence activated. Sufficient fuel to fire primary engine.
I am also just used to games that require you to do heavy melee for like 2/3 of the game.
Did it's working, Isaac. I have a fuel reading. It's only a quarter full, but that's enough to restore orbit once you bring the engines online. False alarm. Thought I saw something.
Well, this guy's playing Five Nights at Freddy's.
Five Nights at Freddy's. Was that the bite of 87? Well, didn't expect that. I thought that was just going to take his body, but nope, took his head.
He's helping you get ahead.
The body was expecting it. It was ahead of the game.
You both fucking suck.
You hush, I don't do puns that often.
I do.
I know.
I'm only encouraging him.
Why'd you do that to Frank?
He was alive, dammit!
You killed Frank, you bastard!
It's okay, I'm fine. Just put me back with my body. Oh.
Oh! Rib?
When did I start playing Burn It With Fire?
Rather get the flamer. The heavy flamer. Thanks,
maybe
game.
To waste the ammo on that. That was adorable, I'd say.
He did his best, man.
A plus. I appreciate it. That was a good.
Yeah.
That was a good.
I have a quota to meet to make that joke every month. But that's about it.
Isaac, where are you? It's me, Nicole.
I don't trust that. I don't trust that.
I trust it.
I don't.
I trust it.
I don't know. The Cole's acting kind of sus.
I don't trust it specifically because you said you trust it.
Oh, okay.
You've played the game, Mister. I've played the game 5 times now, so you know.
5? I thought he said 9.
Nah.
I was being nice.
Oh, wow.
Ding!
Come in. Kendra's right. The ADS is completely shut. I'll need your help to fix this. Kendra, if you can hear me, see if you can get into the ship's reports. It sounds like you have better access from there.
When were you going to tell us about the artifact, Hammond? This marker?
I don't know anything about that. It's referenced in the captain's records. They brought it up from the planet.
It's on the ship?
In cargo. They think it's of alien origin, but I don't know what the hell it is.
Really? CEC didn't know anything about it. You're lying.
Back off! I am not the bad guy here. Ross shake you right now, you're gonna have to trust that I don't know anything about it. We've entered the debris field. Get to the captain's nest. I'll explain everything later. Come on down.
So yeah, this isn't the interesting point yet, but the obvious distrust of everything starts up right about here.
I was like, I kind of agree.
I thought that was already,
yeah, like,
already
she
established.
Did,
I'm like, really? Okay.
Yeah, it's like in the first scene, she's just like, I can't hack the door. What do you want from me?
Like, she already didn't trust him.
Yeah.
But I do agree. He's like acting really weird about it. For being the guy who was commander of this mission and not knowing about it, that's bullshit.
Yeah.
Hello.
All right. Poke your head and see where it goes.
Hello?
Hello?
Oh, I gotta ask, because this was a stupid thought in my head. You know how, like, in, like, Saints Row, they always turn the gun sideways? And it's like, you know,
yeah.
Oh, that's a kill shot. Does this count?
Yes.
Isaac.
Oh.
Damn, you scared me. Place is making me jumpy. Fucking asteroids coming through the roof. Look, I know Kendra doesn't trust me, but I don't know anything about a marker or anything else. This is supposed to be a repair mission. Plain and simple. This mess is the asteroid defense system. I can fix these boards, but the main power routing is shot. You're gonna have to reroute them manually through at least three junction boxes to activate the primary cannon. Oh, but first, you need to activate the atrium elevators from bridge security. You can use them to get to the junction boxes. By the way, Isaac, be careful. I saw something out there. I don't know what. I only got a glimpse. But it was big. Really big.
Oh, gee. I hope it's not like a boss encounter or anything.
I think I already saw it on the way in.
Man, what a shame. My God.
Shit! Stand back! Blah, 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 blah. When I see in the pod. These things don't die easily.
Wait a minute, hang on. Was I the only one who heard that?
What'd you hear?
Right as he was talking through the the communications, mm-hmm. The actual guy in the room, right as the door closed, said, "Get moving."
Oh. Okay, that did not happen last time in any of my freaking playthroughs. Okay, I'm experiencing new things.
Oh no.
Oh no, I played this game 5 times and I'm experiencing new things.
What's going on? They still think this is ridiculous that this is just an engineer.
True, but he is using engineering tools. We don't have the plasma rifle, and that has some weird military shit on it.
I don't know, it's still the fact that this is an engineer going through this and not having any qualms about it. I understand that it's like part of the whole silent protagonist thing, but that's still something that confuses me.
Perhaps you would that's think an engineer when he is voiced.
Maybe.
But don't have to impede on the shit. It doesn't happen that much to me.
Yeah. Okay, here it is,
this
I
is
think.
Mutiny.
Yeah, this is it.
You'll all be tried for mutiny. Kind, make them listen to reason. Settle down, then. Hold him. By maritime law, Article 5469, I hereby declare Captain Benjamin Matthias unfit for duty. The marker must be delivered to the church. Terence, please. I'm sorry, Ben, but I can't let you do this. Traitor! Heretic!
Hold his head.
Murderer! Hold him!
He's dead.
No, it was an accident. I had to stop him.
Arrest the doctor.
How do you accidentally stab somebody in the eye?
They were willingly holding him. As soon as he had the freaking, I guess, either syringe or screwdriver, that'd probably be the point where you're like, hey, this doesn't look right.
That's what I'm saying. It's like, if it's like, who, what trank or like sedative would you apply to the head besides punching them?
Isaac, listen up. I've gone over the MedSci reports. These things are biorecombinators. They take dead tissue, absorb it, and mold it into new forms. One iteration seems to have the sole purpose of infecting corpses. The others, well, seem to be making corpses to infect. And that body tissue we keep seeing on the walls is part of it, too. I found a report that says it's a habitat changer.
Okay, so I guess that takes... You're probably right on that, then, Hunter, with the mutant part instead of the zombies. Yeah.
Yeah, I knew what I was doing. I was right this whole time. I know that.
I wasn't sure about like it directly. I don't remember much of this game. It's just it doesn't seem zombie related.
Oh,
hell?
Oh, Ragdoll.
That needed that freaking, don't you
forget about me.
Processing request. Please stand by. Antigen completed.
Your fight for survival is admirable, but pointless. And yet you keep on going. It almost makes me think that we had hope as a species. And we're the only one who sees that we have died out a long time ago. We just haven't accepted it yet. Stop running. Stop your struggle. Our future, your future, the future of our race ends here. Allow me to introduce you to humanity's child, the children that will replace us, our greatest creation.
Yeah, his character can pretty much just be, I don't think he has like any other moments that are particularly interesting, but he's just kind of a typical science villain.
That's it, Isaac. Now you just need to...
This has gone far enough. Accept your part in the God's plan. Embrace your own extinction.
Warning. Life support system failure on medical deck.
Who the hell was
Please
that?
Please evacuate immediately.
Isaac, he's decompressed the entire deck, and I'm being locked out of those systems. All the air has been vented into space. You should be able to bring it back online from the security station, but you don't have much time.
I completely forgot the flamethrower doesn't work when there's no oxygen in the space.
Yeah, fire kind of needs oxygen to, you know, do the thing. Oh, damn it.
I didn't think that far ahead.
Almost like it makes sense.
It does make sense. I'm out of ammo!
Wow.
Wow.
Why
played this game before.
Yeah. Who'd have thought?
I don't appreciate this.
They knew it was coming.
I feel like I'm dying.
What, the heavy breathing wasn't a dead giveaway?
No. I'm dead. I'm dead. Unless I have an air can somewhere in here. Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Where do I go?
Save. Hey, look, you can save.
Stand
I can't
by
save.
On it.
I can't. I need to turn the oxygen on.
Perhaps now you would understand. The work I have done must continue, will continue. I, Dr. Charles Mercer, shall serve as the catalyst to the salvation of our species. These specimens will return to Earth with me. I will spread their divine glory across the entire planet. I will leave you with my creation. Embrace the inevitable.
It's inevitable, Mr. Anderson.
Sorry, what was that? Something screamed in my face and tried to kill me.
I was making a joke. Don't mind me.
Go on. Let's hear it. Let's hear it.
It is inevitable, Mr. Anderson.
I want my damn phone call.
Mr. Anderson.
Mr. Anderson. Could you imagine if someone made a mod of like that monster just like every time it like finds you it's just like Mr. Anderson.
I would die. Not because I'm scared, because I'm dying laughing. Just after the most suspenseful moment and they try to do another jump scare on you, Mr. Anderson.
Isaac, good to see you in one piece. Don't take your helmet off. The air's rotten.
Why'd I take my helmet off? Look at it.
Why wouldn't I take the helmet off? It's I'm the huge. Silent protagonist. There's no face customization in this. What do you think this is?
Crew that was on this deck. I think they're what's poisoning the air. They've been transformed. I saw one of them. Bloated. Swollen. They're like poison factories. We need to take them out where we can still breathe.
Hammond! I thought you were dead. You need to get to cleaner air. You're not going to be able to help Isaac in your condition. Isaac, I'm scanning the area now. He's right. There's something really big in food storage. But I can't get a good scan. Monitor readings are off the scale. Be careful.
You know, Captain, I seem to be doing a lot of the work here. This might seem like a bad time, but in case we don't make it back, I want to talk about my pay raise.
Listen, we need to talk about my medical bill. Because my back carrying this whole storage. Fucking story is going to be immense.
Is that why he's hunched? He is hunched. That is true.
Just a bit.
So, alternate fires. Obviously, the plasma cutter's got that. Flamethrower. Because of fire blast. And then... This is supposed to be a military weapon, bear in mind, and it has this.
What the fuck?
Okay. Okay. Military weapon, supposed to be in line when you fire your weapon. Oh, I gotta go into the AOE circle, guys!
No, not yet, not yet!
I still don't trust him. I think he's hiding something about the marker.
I don't do a lot of in-game stuff because I don't know how to, and I won't do it without Arsenal's help.
I mean, I'm talking about Swator, not CO. I don't know if you are.
No.
Yeah.
Yeah, that would be the Final Fantasy stuff, right?
What?
What?
Ah, yes, I see there is fire.
Okay. The first time I did this...
I'm on fire!
Not the first time I did this fire!
Not the first time I did this budding.
Could not have been timed better. I was... Last time I played this and it opens up and I'm like, uh-oh.
What? No. Oh my god. I can just see it now. It's just a compilation of... I've played this game many times before. I know the ins and outs. It just shows a compilation of every time Arsenal's fucked up.
God, that'd be perfect. I ran out of ammo!
Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do.
I mean, I'm sure I made like I oh right. I have to correct this thing I said in last recording. So I said in the old, what the fuck am I saying? In the remake they're using the Unreal Engine. Not true. Okay, you don't have to be that upset that I got that wrong. No. It is not on the Unreal Engine. It's on the Frostbite engine. And that's the ones you see with the Battlefield games. So that's one thing I have to correct. But that's for the remake. That I'm pretty sure I've gotten a couple things wrong with this game so far.
Do you want to tell them about the Havoc system?
Oh yeah, the Havoc system is the one that's used for the Tiger Woods games. If you're that old,
who knows?
This is Temple, acting chief engineer. I came down here to find Dr. Elizabeth Cross, but she's not here. In fact, I can't find anyone. Just more of this organic shit everywhere.
I'm sorry. Wait, can you look back at that again?
I'm going to check the mining deck. It's back at the TV screen. I haven't looked yet.
Oh my god, they got an alphabet.
Yeah, people tried to figure this one out.
Interesting.
Yeah, they got... With all the symbols that you can find on the wall, you can't actually piece together what they say.
Future astronaut, I'll find the answer to that. Go!
Am I... Oh, no! Oh, no!
I played this game before, guys! It's okay!
It's okay! Everything is fine! It's just more fuel for the after credits.
Die, testicle man.
That's the last one, Isaac. There's a switch in atmosphere control to restart the oxygen recycling. Once the air's clean, you can get...
I was going to say his name was Harry, but he's not that hairy.
You may think I didn't hear that, but I did. Freaking Kendra was giving a serious moment and you were talking about that.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah, but to recap, she was describing the effects of the so-called marker giving hallucinations, and she didn't believe it at first, but she said she just saw her brother on the security monitors and pretty much said, that's impossible, he's been dead. So, there you go. To fill that in for somebody that was talking about freaking Harry Osborne.
Yeah, we'll go with that, sure.
Absolutely. All
those hallucinations of all the dead loved ones.
I like Spider-Man too.
For how entirely unprepared I was for this recording, I don't have water, and now I'm regretting not having water.
Well, you can get water if you want.
I'm going to. I'll be right
back.
We're
only
don't
like 30 minutes away from being done.
Yeah, don't die without me.
I forgot they stand all calmly. They're like, he's back!
Oh, he's going on. Oh, he's back! He's on! Oh, he's back!
Oh, my cat has found out that I have water and has therefore confiscated it.
Hydroponics log, this is Dr. Cross. It's hard for me to believe what I'm seeing here. This is crazy. Absolutely crazy. I'm going to the mining deck. I hear that's where survivors are gathering. Jacob, I'll wait for you there.
Unknown antigen injected into the filtration system.
Damn it. The poison wasn't strong enough. Still alive. Get in there and kill it before it contaminates the entire ship.
I don't like how it prompts me to do that.
Oh my god.
Yeah, I love this boss battle.
I will defeat you with the power of zero gravity and this engineering gun I found.
The power of Floki.
I don't know.
Exiting zero gravity.
Usually that boss would be a lot harder, but I've actually fully upgraded shit.
On a positive note, I've played this game before.
On a positive note, I've played this game before.
Not like our usual negative connotation, this is actually a good thing.
Yeah.
Hell yeah, let's go, brother!
I feel like we need a key and I'm not remembering this correctly.
I played this game before.
Stop it.
I know what I'm doing. This is nice.
That's a very lovely neighborhood.
Are you guys seeing something I don't not seeing? Don't fucking even say a word. It's a big rock, all right? It's hard to aim. Is that not? Okay, that didn't count. I had to be sure.
I've played this game before.
Please recycle any unused materials regularly. Thank you.
That was good shooting, Arsenal. Good job. Thank you very much.
No.
Eh.
What?
If this is cosmetic, by the way.
I'm fucking really upset about it right now.
Oh, hello.
Oh.
It did feel like he said hello there, didn't he?
Yeah.
He was being friendly and just shot his head off.
Isaac?
Oh, hello.
Is that really you? It feels like it's been so long. But I can help you now. Come with me.
Do it. Do it. Do it.
Okay, the door's unlocked, Isaac. I can't get over to you, but I'll find a way.
Good jump.
I love you. This will all be over soon.
Active time maneuver. Oh, nope, didn't reach her. She's falling.
Is there a safe station back there? If anyone knows the giant camera icon.
Exiting
I do not.
Zero gravity.
Okay, because I know I'm gonna at some point I'm gonna die at this
entering
one. This
zero gravity.
Stuff.
But ours.
What?
But ours.
I've played
so
this game before.
You know.
I know. Jesus.
You've played this game before. You should be able to one-shot it.
Things are looking up. A military ship just docked in. The USM Valor. I don't know what it was doing out there. It must have gotten our distress signal. We can't talk to it until the comms array is fixed. I'm gonna hack the door to communications for you. Get in there and find the comms control station.
Should that have been our first move, is get the communications array working instead of sending out the asteroid with the SOS signal on it?
Plot direction.
Don't worry about it.
I'm worrying about it.
You don't. There's no point now.
It's a plot narrative. It's why we're doing this.
Gotta, you know, stretch the game out a bit.
You gotta make sure that you keep everyone on their toes. Logic doesn't mean anything when plot.
I need
is more
my
important.
Logic in my games.
But do you
in
though?
In my story, well.
Communications array.
I was like, what is he talking about? Oh.
I'm running on 3 hours of sleep.
Goodness.
I'm running on one.
Am I the only one who got some actual sleep here? What the fuck?
He knocked the freaking head and it was on fire. Communications array. What's it trying to say? I don't know yet.
I don't speak in Morse code.
Zero 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 one zero one zero 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 one one. You need to talk about that, buddy?
I don't know what you're talking about.
You need to talk about your hand-eye coordination? Maybe your hand-foot coordination?
Yeah, let's talk about that one, actually.
like how so casually he holds it now. It's just like, eh. This is getting kind of boring.
I really hope there would be a... I can imagine, like, in the remake, they just have him, kind of like in the first couple hours of the game, he's kind of shaky with his aim, and then, like, later on, he's just like, oh, fuck, not again.
Just another day in paradise.
This is USM Valor, widecasting on all frequencies to USGE Shimura in response to your SOS. We've picked up your escape pod, number 47, and are route to your position. This message will repeat every 30 seconds until you respond.
I was gonna say, don't worry about it.
Go with it.
Everything is fine.
Mr. Anderson.
Mr. Anderson, I brought you this lift to help you.
Oh, well, goodbye.
Goodbye. Help me.
That was terrifying.
That was more terrifying than the actual horror in this game.
I know that's like an unpopular opinion, but it's true. Dead Space 1 is not the scariest in the series.
I mean, it's exploring new boundaries. Can't really play it.
I mean, it's a fucking awesome world to be in. If you don't mind the monsters.
Bobbing out to the elevator jams.
Yeah. I didn't open that.
Yeah, I was going to say, like, damn, you really are taking this force thing to a whole new level.
I need that. Give it to me. Hello? The box open, that's all.
Why does the security phone look like a fire alarm pole station? Why did you shoot the fire alarm pole station?
There's no fire here.
Bitch! What the fuck are you talking about? You're carrying a flamethrower! Fuck you!
There's no fire here.
There is no fire in Boss Six.
There's no fire here. There's no fire. Don't worry about it.
Manual override initiated.
I don't mean to be cynical!
Get off my plane.
Opening communications array.
Of existence, sir.
Yes.
USM Valor, this is Kendra Daniels on the USG Ishimura. Come in. Do not open the escape pod. USM Valor, this is Kendra Daniels on the USG Ishimura. Come in. Do not open the escape pod. Damn it! Respond!
Stop, too late.
Yep. Iron Man, no!
Why did they open the pod? Damn it.
Why would they not open the pod? It was an SOS.
It's headed right for us. Isaac! Isaac!
It's coming right for us!
Oh no.
So, fun fact, not a story-based thing, but...
I wish I could just talk to someone. It's all falling apart here.
I'm sorry, your story is not important. Isaac. But clearly it's Dead Space, this is.
Isaac, there? Thank God you're alright. I've been trying to reach you. Someone's been blocking my rig signal remotely. A crash must have interrupted the signal block.
Hammond, where have you been?
Surviving. Barely. I found some med supplies and packed myself up. Listen. I'm calling abort on the mission. Fuck the CEC and fuck the chain of command. We have to get the hell out of here. I think I've located a shuttle on the crew deck. Flight log says it needs a new singularity core, but we can probably salvage one from the Valor. I can see the tail end of it sticking out from the side of the Ishimura. I'm headed down there now to find a way inside. I'll meet you there. Hammond out.
Isaac, if what he says is true about the shuttle, we might have a chance of getting out of here. Head to the cargo bay and see if you can help Hammond. In his condition, he may not last long.
In his condition?
I don't know what she means by that still to this day. I guess if he said he's surviving barely, that might answer that, but I don't know how long he's been surviving, and I don't know what his combative skills are.
He doesn't sound like he's having problems.
He doesn't sound like he's having problems, though. That's kind of sus. You just hopped into the vent, guys.
I do find it really stupid, though, and obviously we can cover more of it after we do the final chapter, that somehow a entire ship of military forces cannot kill one necromorph.
Hehehe. But an engineer can!
Absolutely.
Good, you made it inside. Listen, I just found the munitions log for the Valor. I don't think their presence here is a coincidence. They're not on reconnaissance, and they're not on patrol. This ship is prepped for war. They're on a seek and destroy mission. Do you hear me?
Isaac, I've lost him again. No signal from Hammond's rig. Find the Singularity Core and get the hell out of there.
After I make my guns go pew pew. Oh, fuck it. Jesus Christ! Everything that's just out of screen is just, it's a perfect way of using third-person horror. I forgot to reload.
Okay!
In fact, he's doing something strange to these soldiers. They all have built-in stasis units in their body armor. The infection is merging the stasis unit into their flesh or something, making them move fast. Real fast. Be careful.
I'm scenic now. You made three of those six shots count.
I don't like the way they move.
Yeah, they're a one-time enemy, and I wish they used them more. They are a little bit more horror-inducing than... ...than your standard necromorphs. What if I don't want to?
How about no?
Better idea. No.
No.
Isaac, I'm tracking your position, but it doesn't look like I can reach you. This damn ship was nearly shared in half. I made it to the bridge. It's a mess here. These poor bastards didn't stand a chance.
Somehow.
I'm going to override all door locks so you can get to the engine room. I'll try and catch up with you there.
Sorry.
Okay, but hear me out on this.
I'm ready.
Stormtroopers. These soldiers have stormtrooper logic.
Mr. Clark, I need to speak with you.
No.
My name is Terence Kine, Dr. Kine. Listen to me. There isn't much time. If you really can repair the shuttle, there is a better use for it than just running away. You must understand, the forces at work here are greater than you can imagine. If you leave now, you condemn all humanity. The planet will never stop, never rest, unless the marker is returned. Don't you see? The church is wrong. This is all a trap. I've seen it. Please, you must help me.
Okay.
Oh,
killed him with his own, with your own mere presence. I mean, the blood loss was probably also another thing, but still, goddamn, Isaac is too powerful.
What is this?
That's just insult to injury.
He was asking for it. Alright. I don't even know what killed him.
The lasers!
The lasers weren't even pointed there yet.
Yes, they were!
Why do they keep... I'm not firing at it. Why do they keep dying over there?
I don't know. I do have a question, though.
What is said question?
So, like, we can, like, safely assume that these creatures are based off of, like, they're churned humans by the whole whatever's going on, right?
Mm-hmm.
So it's safe to assume those things were changed, were babies that were changed, right?
Right.
Why are they on this military ship?
I assume because they are crashed into the Ishimura ship, they crawled into it at some point.
That's fair, but it's just like, why are there babies on a military ship?
Unless they do some like, really questionable recruiting.
It's like, what the heck is going on?
Yeah, it is a fair question.
I don't think I want to know the answer to that.
Neither do I, but it's a question I had because it's like, wait a minute.
Yeah.
It makes sense why they're on the Ishimura, but...
I don't need that much ammo. I've played this game before.
I'll show you.
Engine power failure.
Is that it? You got it? Oh my god! You got it! That's the piece we need. Get to the crew deck.
Get to the crew deck.
Get to the crew deck.
The crew deck.
Mr. Anderson!
Isaac! Over here! I've been trying to reach you, my comm was out.
I'm over here.
You got the singularity core, that's not taking out of here. Get that comm to shuttle! Don't wait for me! Oh, fuck me! Ah!
Oh, he's dead now.
Oh.
Oh.
Oh, ow. Ooh. That's just, ooh.
Very, very dead. Oh, God.
So you were asking about his combat skills?
None. I was.
Literally none.
Well, I'm sure he had, like, none. Now he definitely has none.
I just lost all of Hammond's vitals. Is he dead? Oh god. It's just us now, Isaac.
You wanted him dead at the beginning of the game.
Yes, this is true. I want him. I want Lance Reddick. Throw him in the flames!
Warning. Catastrophic failure of fuel containment. Evacuate the vessel immediately.
You're gonna take him with you all the way to the crew deck, aren't you? Now, before you purchase those nodes, ask yourself, do you need ammo?
I'm glad you asked yourself this question before we had problems.
What do you cling to when all must seem so utterly hopeless around you? Dr. Cross was a true. She had fate, and now she awaits her transformation, her rebirth. Are you ready to ascend, Mr. Temple? Of course you are. Have no fear. You will play your part soon enough. Witness the conviction of a true believer! They are ready. Take them. Embrace them.
That walk animation.
Can I just point out that it was utterly pointless about having that huge ass wall of text?
Yeah.
Like, okay.
This was before they had that congruency of maybe we should do it in tweets instead of passages.
I know, but it's like if you like trying to reread that and then like trying to like if you actually couldn't hear the game and you were mm-hmm. relying on those, that just sounds wild.
Mm-hmm. It does mess with the pacing. Oh wow, okay, I actually killed it. Alright.
You're better than you thought you were.
I played this game before. We're back.
Oh no.
Oh hey, I played this game before.
I don't like those noises. And I know that's probably like they took audio from a dog snarling, but ugh.
Yeah, and like lowered the pitch down by like probably 10 dBs or something.
Away from the church at this vital hour. Do not abandon your faith. What's happening on the colony is not a tragedy. It's God's truth is even more fantastic. On the planet Lost, we have found a marker. God's plan is unfolding and we are its inheritors. We will ascend as we always knew we would. Unitology is truth. And your death is the first phase. We deterred by the physical methods of transformation. Soon, you will be beyond any physical concerns. You must have faith, fools. This is what we have been searching for all these years. This is what we have been waiting for. Don't listen to them. Come back. Come back. How can you be turning away from the church in this vital hour? Do not abandon your faith. What's happening?
I'd say that's his motivation, but it doesn't really answer why he's doing all he's doing.
I mean, he's enforcing the will of what he believes in on these people because they don't want to accept what he believes God's plan is.
Yeah.
And so like, you don't really need any other motivation.
I suppose if everybody wasn't turning into a dead corpse, he'd probably have more of a religious following.
Probably. I mean, you never know. Some people probably believe him. Like, not everyone, but he's probably has some people who believed he was right.
Yeah. Oh. That's an error. I shouldn't be able to see that.
Hang on a second, sir. The video game is broken. Oh my god. Whoever, like, did that, like, must have, like, strained their throat.
Man, that joke was so good, it blew her mind.
What?
Okay, well, I'll be here all week. I suspect he, like, unthawed it or something. Oh.
Isaac, that son of a bitch just overrode the door lock. I'll try to run a bypass. Hold on.
So does being on a ship, like, give you technical knowledge on how to override door locks and shit? Because there's a lot of people who just happen to be, like, overriding doors and causing problems.
What are your qualifications? Can you hack a door?
Most people can, apparently.
Yeah. The future.
Excellent work, Mr. Clark. Excellent work. Now, come and meet me in the executive area. The door is unlocked. Be quick.
Isaac, be careful with Dr. Kine. A lot of what I've discovered so far has come from his records. The man has clearly gone insane. He might be unstable. Maybe.
He's Christ,
plasma energy.
Cutter, yeah, my friggin' plasma cutter needs all the ammo in the world.
It's a plasma cutter that you're using for the wrong purpose.
It's supposed to be for engineering, not a weapon.
That's the point of it, but apparently, no, it's a weapon now.
It is a weapon now.
Seriously, Isaac's in the wrong fucking profession.
To be an engineer, they said. It'll be fun, they said.
And no one said anything about fighting aliens to death.
Oh look, Hunter, it's another wall of text.
You've made it! Oh, thank God you made it. I've been following your progress. I know you want to repair the executive shuttle and leave this place, but escape is impossible at this point. The shuttle shock point drive is destroyed. No. Don't lose hope. Don't lose hope. At first, I lost hope. I tried to scuttle the ship, sabotage the systems. But Amelia, she changed things. The church, they think the marker is divine. But they don't know what's happened here, what's been released. Look. Look at this. That is what we found in the core of the planet. Mercer calls it the hive mind. It's the source, controlling the necromorphs telepathically. We were so stupid! But Amelia, she knew it could be stopped by returning the marker to the planet. The marker was containing it within the planet. Return the marker and seal the hive mind. Please, I'm sorry, Amelia. I bear much of the responsibility for this tragedy. Now, I must take responsibility for ending it. And atone for my sins. But you can help me. If you repair the shuttle and bring the marker back on board...
Miss Click, sorry.
We can end this. Forever.
It was a very tense moment that you just kind of ruined with your... Like, for as weird as that guy's face looked, he's the only one who's made sense so far.
Apart from Hammond.
I mean, Hammond, I'm still concerned.
Hammond is a blithering idiot!
Yeah, I don't know how to feel about Hammond. Hammond went from, like, being really stupid, like, stupid in the, like, suspicious way, to just being stupid. I'm still mad at Hammond, and I don't think he was very well good of a character.
Well, we'll get to that later.
I know, but I'm just saying now. I really don't like Hammond.
I gotcha. Wait, am I already on my... Wow, okay.
Yeah, I don't know.
For an engineering equipment, yeah, plasma cutter burns through pretty quick.
Piece of engineering equipment, what do you want
from it? Engineering tools.
Yeah, what do you want from it?
How many nails do you put in a nail gun, Marley?
Well, that's not my profession. So
what is your profession?
I'm a fire alarm guy, dude.
He fixes fire alarms.
Oh my god, you just brought that freaking fire alarm joke full circle. I didn't even realize that. Well, that clip's gonna have full context.
Captain's log, personal. I want to set the record straight. By the time this log is heard, my actions will have been vindicated. I'm a unitologist. By now, it's probably no secret that we shouldn't be in this star system. Just another illegal mining job for the company. That is, until the colony found the marker. That was when the church took an interest and chose me to lead this pilgrimage. They also ensured many of the mission crew were devout. My primary instruction was to get the marker up from the colony and on board the ship. Dr. Kine, the CSO, is an expert on the original marker and was tasked with deciphering this new one. He says he's making good progress. My decision to quarantine the colony is sound. They've got some kind of epidemic down there, and I can't allow it to infect the ship. Not with such precious cargo. Not when we are so close. Planet Crack takes place tomorrow. We'll continue to decipher the marker, and when we return home, we'll pass all our findings and the marker to the church. The government isn't going to cover this one up. Altman be praised.
Why? I don't understand what makes them think it's divine. It's a random-ass object they found on a planet not of our world or universe. Why is it divine? I don't get it.
I suppose that it'd be like they bring the dead back to life in some way. That'd probably be their argument.
I don't know. I feel like they're not putting in a big enough effort of explaining why they praise it so well. I don't know. I may have just been missing context. I don't know.
I'm with you in the same boat.
Yeah.
It's just paranoia and otherworldly stuff.
I guess.
I will agree that there's missing context to explain the Unitologist's motive besides religion.
If I could kind of understand, like, what about this marker makes them believe that it's a holy symbol, maybe I wouldn't be so upset about it. But it's just, I don't know. It just doesn't make any sense to me.
I agree.
Unless they, like, have some strange religion that, like, weaves itself around that marker because people worship things they don't understand, then that's fine. But they're comparing it to, like, the already standard religion.
Yeah, we'd have to get into theology, unfortunately, and it probably... We'll have to wait if the game would explain it later on, either in this game or in future installments.
I don't know.
I actually do not recall if the first game actually does it give them a strong enough motive to make sense.
I'm not trying to shit on the game. This is a fantastic game, but God, some of this context is missing.
Test firing shuttle engines.
He's doing Sorry, it. He's doing his best. I don't know what he's doing, but he's doing it.
This time.
So instead of freezing him, we're setting him on fire.
Disintegrating him, yep.
That's fair. I feel like we should have done that the first time.
He's fucking slowly walking around.
It works. Yes, this will work. There's still time to make things right. The shuttle needs to be released before launch. The control platform there. I need you to guide the undocking procedure while I start the shuttle's engines. This will make us whole again. Hurry! I'll take the shuttle up to the flight deck where the marker's being held.
He's gonna leave with the shuttle, isn't he?
Shuttle locks disengaged.
I'm en route to the flight deck. Meet me there and we can load the marker on board. Yes, Amelia. Soon we'll take it home.
I don't know if Kine is crazy or not, but we need that shuttle. Let's keep him on our side. For now.
See, I like her. She's got sense.
Pretty quiet lately, though.
I mean, true.
Your time has come. No need to be frightened. No reason to fight. Many have gone before us, and now it's time for us to take the voyage together. Transcend death. The future take its course. Join me as I gaze upon the face of God.
Okay. So Mercer's dead now.
Well, he'll be back, I'm sure. Just not in the way we, like, not in the alive way.
Alright.
Delivering cargo shipment 782. Kinesis module required for further cargo transport.
I restored power to the elevator. Take it up to the hangar bay and get the marker on the shuttle. I'm heading up to the flight deck now. Oh god. I'm just gonna run for it. Wish me luck.
On the comment about the fact that you said that she's been quiet a lot of this time, it's probably because that she's literally in an area where they're near and she's trying not to be noticed.
Yeah, she's in that computer core still, I think.
Yeah, she was trying not to be heard, so that's why she's been as quiet as she is. Really only saying anything that's important.
Fair enough.
Excellent. I'm going to dock the shuttle. Got to be careful now. Careful. I'm bringing the shuttle down now. The automated loading controls aren't responding. You'll have to shut down gravity in the hangar bay, and then manually bring the marker directly beneath the shuttle.
Entering zero gravity.
You know, zero gravity might sound fun, but if I can't stop myself from flying too fast into a wall and splattering, I'm probably not gonna have fun.
Absolutely not.
Exiting zero gravity. Loading cargo shipment 782.
It's on board. Please come and join me. Together we can stop this hive mind. We can end this nightmare at last.
Sorry, Isaac. I couldn't let him go through with it. I suppose I should thank you for finding the marker. We even managed without help from the USM Valor. Thank you for helping me find it, by the way. My department's been looking for this place for a long time. See what Kine didn't know was? It was the government's mess to begin with. This whole planet is one big experiment. The marker? This divine relic? Made by man. They reverse-engineered it a couple of hundred years ago from the real marker, a true alien artifact recovered on Earth. They dug it up, studied it, and they made it their own. Then they brought it to Aegis 7 and activated it. And you've seen the result. The stuff of nightmares. They sealed the system, and no one would have been the wiser. But then the CEC blunders in and starts tearing the planet apart. The experiment was still alive. Kine was right about the hive mind. The marker would contain it, but that doesn't matter now, does it? I have the marker, and this entire system can go to hell. For what it's worth, you did a great job, Isaac. See you around. Or maybe not. Isaac, Nicole, I need you to help me. Help us, now! I'm in the flight control room. Please, Isaac, hurry! Please!
All right, cool.
Yep.
Yeah, right, well, that sounds about right.
Yeah, that's about right. I was literally like, Randy was like, we could do this, we could get out of here. I literally thought to myself, all right, what's the catch? And there went the catch.
Yep, there was the catch.
But, all right, whatever.
Ooh, what was that? Ammo for gun.
Ammo for engineering tools.
For engineering tools.
Isaac? Is that really you? I never thought we'd be together again. God, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry for what I did. I never wanted to hurt you. You need to get it back now, Isaac. You can pilot the shuttle remotely from here. Make us whole again. Make us whole again.
Look, lady, you're obviously not real.
I don't know, that seems pretty normal to me.
Like, there's nothing about her that says she's real.
Isaac, what the hell are you doing? You're making a big mistake. This is not over.
Right, you made the mistake first. And believing that an engineer couldn't stop
escape
you.
Escape pod away, crew shuttle USG-09. Repeat. Shuttle has ejected escape pod.
It doesn't matter. She can't escape her fate. None of us can.
Here it comes. I'll reprogram the shuttle so we can fly down to the colony. God, we're so close, Isaac. Now go! Get on the shuttle. I'll meet you there.
Isaac did a little bit of a shuffle there to get to the chair.
You're doing the right thing, Isaac. We're together now. The way it always should have been. I knew you'd come back for me. Nothing could stop us now.
Communications ring.
Isaac, the marker needs to be returned to the pedestal chamber. Use the loader to bring it there and place it on the pedestal. Replace what was taken and make us whole again.
I get it. Make us whole again. They wanted to imply the fact that she wasn't real any harder.
It's not much of a... Well, I don't say anything else. I can't say anything.
That's fair. Even if she is real, it's obvious she's not herself, so it's like, whatever. She might as well not be real.
I thought you were about to say, she might as well die.
No. Oh. That was odd.
That was like one of those school kids coming up to the teacher like, what'd I do wrong now?
Goodness. Derby AI.
I've never seen them do that.
Thank you, Isaac. I always believed in you. I knew you'd return to me. We are whole again, Isaac. We are whole.
Emergency. Geo-orbital gravity tethers offline. Tectonic load released. Impact imminent. Evacuate this area immediately.
Oops. There we go.
Decontamination cycle activated.
Isaac. You really didn't think I was just gonna walk away, did you? I can't do that. The marker's coming with me. It's a shame. I was starting to like you. Even if you are insane. What, you don't believe me? Take a look at yourself. Better yet, take a look at the video from Nicole. And this time, watch it right to the end.
Isaac, it's me. I wish I could talk to you. I'm sorry. I'm sorry about everything. I wish I could just talk to someone. It's all falling apart here. I can't believe what's happening. It's strange. It's such a little thing. In the end, it all comes down to this one little thing. I didn't want it to end like this. I really wanted to see you again. Just once. I loved you. I always loved you.
Say that was a plot twist, but I feel like we all saw it coming.
Yeah.
I mean, I kept calling that she wasn't real.
Yeah. Probably the big factor was it was that was pretty much the only interaction we saw from Isaac in the entire game.
Oh my god. Why she didn't expect it to kill her. Like, really?
What's that thing?
Like, she knew it was there. And the fact that she thought it would let her walk away is ignorance and stupidity.
True.
It's even worse when you realize that she knew, like, how the thing worked.
I would not want to be in this position.
Like, how can you aim like that?
I really can't.
Cool, like, cinematic-wise, but terrible in, like, controlling.
I got lucky on that shot.
It worked out.
Thank you. did it.
I'm proud of you.
We saved the city.
I don't know what we saved, but it wasn't a city.
Look at how many people we saved. Me.
Look at how many people. All one of us.
So that plant's gonna be dead for a while.
You could say it's going to stay idle in...
Shut up.
Dead space.
I don't know what you expected. Isaac has a face.
Man, that receding hairline. I'm more sorry about that than him losing his wife.
I mean, to be fair.
Girlfriend. It's not a ring on there.
Close enough.
Isaac, it's me. I wish I could talk to you. I'm sorry.
And jump scares. Jump scares suck.
I'm legitimately confused now. I didn't actually fully see what it was, probably because of my stream quality.
It was her.
That's fair. Like, literally, he's been mind controlled by this thing this whole time. That doesn't surprise me.
It's true.
He's going to have problems.
Okay, so that was Dead Space. Any closing thoughts on that before we get into final scores and all that? Who wants to start?
Well, don't let everyone jump up at once.
It's like nobody did anything.
Okay, fucking hell, I'll fucking stop. Alright. This is
the sixth time I've played it now.
Shut up.
I've played this game before!
I don't even know what the counter is now. For the sixth time, it's still my favorite franchise in the horror genre. It's not the best of them, but you know, it still stands up. What Visceral Games had to work with, it's still pretty impressive. So that's pretty much my thoughts on that for final.
I mean, to be fair, considering I haven't watched this game before, I understand why it's considered a very, like, one of the more popular game series, especially in the horror genre, because that's fair. There's a lot going on in there.
Art style alone, it really stands on its own.
Like, yeah, and it didn't do the whole stereotypical zombie thing. It had its own flavor to it. I mean, it's a good game.
I would agree with that. It is... To its own degree and standard, it is probably a really good game for its time. And I think after seeing it played, I would say that it's aged like a fine wine. I mean, you can clearly see it's dated, but it still has its touch. It still has its flavor.
It's still a good game for being as old as it was.
Yes.
Correct. Any other thoughts anyone wants to put out there?
Not really. The only other thing is I'm really curious what they're going to do with the remake.
That's true. I mean, Isaac's going to be voiced now.
Yeah, I'm wondering how much more character is going to be put into it, because let's remind ourselves, like, this is an aged game. They uploaded it in an age where dialogue and story wasn't entirely prevalent, where it was more... focus on the gameplay, or for some places I won't say the lack thereof, but you can tell that the gameplay was kind of a little cut and dry.
Mm-hmm.
But that seemed to be a little bit more of where they were focused.
Yeah.
So I don't know what's going to happen in that remake, but I mean, from a story standpoint, because, you know, this is a whole narrative review and everything, I would love to see that character a little bit more fleshed out. But for what it was and the time that it was given, I would say this game did meet its standard quo.
Mm-hmm. I agree.
I do agree with people that, yes, that was really good for what it was.
Yeah. Okay, so with that then, we're going to break down the narrative storytelling of it with the intro, the inciting incident, midpoint, rising action, climax, and then the denouement, or the resolution.
Denouement!
Yeah. So the intro, we'll pretty much say, was the obviously the starting point to chapter 2, I'd say. Maybe chapter 3. A bit of a... I would say a slower start would probably help it more. It's very loud and in your face, and that does not really help a horror game. It just becomes more jump scary, per se. It just it doesn't really sit well with me personally, but I feel like you get more of the horror when you're actually slow and taking your time.
I would say, honestly, like compared to some of the other horror games I've played, this one was probably a little bit more on the slow end. It wasn't really, honestly, as much in your face. At least that's how I perceived it while you were playing it.
Yeah, I was taking my time, especially.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I haven't played a lot of horror games, so I'll defer to your judgment on that one.
As a horror game?
Well, like generally, it's like I don't know. Like I know like how horror games work. Like, I understand, like I said, some are slow, some are fast, but I don't, like, I couldn't judge this one directly, because I don't play enough horror games to compare it to.
Oh, I would say it's okay. For an entry into a new franchise, it's, you know, it's good.
Mm.
It could be worse. It could have just been... I don't know, it could have been copying Resident Evil, and it didn't do that. So, on the inciting incident then, that would be pretty much the reveal of the necromorphs, and the potential of, or, well, the clues leading to the marker. That's a pretty simple one. Inciting incidents are essentially what gets the plot moving. I think there's more than enough motivation for Isaac to be involved in this. He wants to find his girlfriend, Nicole. Hammond is following orders. We later find out that he may or may not know something about the marker, but he focuses more on escaping. And then Kendra, as far as we know, was saying that she was more interested in escaping, but she probably wanted the marker more than anything.
I mean, clearly, it's like her little way, she says, my organization was looking for this.
Hmm.
I mean, that's later in hindsight, given the situation of where you are in the game and the topic we're talking about. It's clear that they both have their different motives from the get-go. And while Isaac might not give a shit as a character, you as a player, if you're paying attention to the story, can immediately perceive this setup was not intentional. And now you got both sides clashing, which honestly, I feel like, yeah, I ripped on the character a little bit, but that still is good character. You can't have everyone working together and making everything hunky-dory. Like, the clash between the two while you were trying to do what you were working on is actually pretty solid. Because not only are you having the tension with the necromorphs, you're having the tension with your own party.
Mm-hmm.
And eventually it's going to come to a head.
Yeah. And when you say ripping on the character, you mean specifically just Hammond, right?
No, I mean like ripping on how like bland the starting acting and the character was. Like, you could tell like it was a last minute afterthought from most characters.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. That's what I was mainly getting at. I mean, I will still quote Clarkson to this day, Hammond is a blithering idiot. So, yeah, Hammond's just a fucking idiot that was placed in charge. And then we know what happens with the other gal.
Yeah. It does become a bit of a whodunit at the, near the midpoint of the plot, where someone starts hacking, Hammond's rig and he can't contact. We don't find out who did that as far as I recall. We only have like a few suspects on that. That could be either Kendra, that could have been Dr. Kynes, or that could have been Dr. Mercer. I would lean on saying that Kendra was probably doing it though.
So if you want to think about like what those other two like did as professions, Kendra is the likelier suspect.
Absolutely. The other two are, one's a unitologist and one's a doctor, as far as I, or whatever the captain said, COS, I think it was. So yeah, it's probably, I'm not sure why she would particularly do that. She probably like too much of a distrust, I guess. It doesn't serve her if both of them die, though.
Yeah, I think she just wanted him out of the way.
Yeah. Like, just have Isaac do all the lifting.
Yeah, so instead of his attention being split between what she wants to do and what he's trying to do, it's just get rid of the problem.
Yeah. The thing I don't get is that she's a... an agent for the government of Earth, as far as she's told us. She only had, like, a sidearm as a weapon, so I'm not sure how skilled she is in combat. I can believe Captain Hammond having skill in combat until he came across the brute that would kill him, but for Kendra and Mercer and Kynes, I don't know how they survived as long as they did on the Yoshimura.
There's no telling. It's small plot things that we don't know much about.
Mm-hmm. Rising action would be, unless, does somebody else want to throw something in on that?
Nope. I think we're all good.
Okay, so on the resin action, that would be finding the marker and then getting onto the shuttle. I think that probably was the fastest the plot was ever moving, that we actually found the source of everything. I'm a little bit confused, though. But we'll have to talk about that later, because it's not really talked about in this game. They say the hive mind controls the necromorphs, and the marker is like a way to contain them, but also the marker causes hallucinations, I guess. I guess you could look at it as like medication. It like causes side effects. Side effects, Mike, includes your death. And then the climax, I mean, not much to say on the rising action. It's pretty simple stuff. The climax being, everyone knows what the climax is. The highest point in the story, which would be on the mining colony with the hive mine and getting the marker there to contain it, and then the final battle there. Is there really much to say? It's just kind of a big baddie.
Not really a whole lot to say. I mean, I don't know. I don't feel like, for me, there's a whole lot to really say around the ending, because it's the climax, the resolution, and the finale of all of it. I don't know. It just, for its time, they all seem pretty general.
Mm-hmm.
You did the thing, you did a good job, but you didn't really do it.
Yeah.
It's like, congratulations, you killed the thing, now what?
Yeah.
Like, what do you do now?
Yeah. And again, like, how it ends is like, you did it, but you didn't really do it. Like, it's kind of like the premonition of like, oh yeah, there's going to be a second one. Maybe. Possibly. Don't know yet, but we're going to leave you on that cliffhanger because we don't like you.
Yeah, Sequel Bay is such a pain in the ass when it comes to writing. Like, just wrap things up. If you're going to do a full story, just at least tie something in to wrap up this segment of your story. Or at least the arc.
Yeah.
Which then leads us into the denouement, or the resolution, which is just the ghost on your ship.
The ghost on your ship.
Hey, happy horror.
Happy jump scare, there you go. Yeah, I mean, it's again, Dead Space is a pretty simple story. It didn't really have to put on a big resolution. The whole thing was Isaac coming to grips on a video clip he received from his girlfriend. He didn't watch it till the end. Presumably, he knew what happened to her. But on an off chance that he found her alive, since he didn't watch the videotape to the end, or the video clip, or whatever you want to call it, transmission, whatever. Just some chance is probably what he was looking for.
Yeah. Which is fair. It's like a holding on to a false hope that you're not gonna, that you'll get, everything will be okay.
Mm-hmm. I do want to say, though, you did bring up that Kendra did know that the Hive Mind was on the planet. Like, why the hell was she standing there?
Like, I don't know. It's just like, I'm not nitpicking it. It's just, it's one of those things of like, you're acting like the big bad person. You finally got what she came here for. You did all this stuff, and you think it's just gonna let you leave?
I'll bet you in a rough draft, she did get on the shuttle, and the Hive Mind grabbed the shuttle and, like, crashed it down to the planet. That was probably, like, the thing of, like, oh, shit, we don't have an escape vessel now.
Yeah, that's the thing. That would have been, like, more realistic to me. Like, that would have made more sense. Like, when she sees it come out, she's like, oh, shit, I gotta go, and then, like, tries to leave, and it destroys the shuttle. Yeah, you lose your chance of escape, but it makes more sense.
If she was not close to the shuttle, then maybe it would have been believable, but she was, like, right there.
Mm-hmm. I don't know. It was... I don't know if it's that much of a big deal, but it's just one of those small things I, like, have to scratch my head at.
Yeah, I mean, acting-wise, everyone did a freaking great job, but it's little beats that they were tripping on in the story.
It's like, it's good acting, the audio's good, it's a good game. It's just small things. Like, the way they had to make the story work.
True. Okay, so unless we have anything else we want to add to that, we can move on to our favorite characters and our least favorite characters.
I mean, like, you could say that Isaac was a cool character, but honestly, I still like Kendra. Even for her stupidity at the end.
I'll list out the characters before we go on to that. Because he had his one little moment, we'll put Isaac as a potential candidate on there. Captain Hammond, Kendra Daniels, Dr. Terrence Kynes, Dr. Chalice Mercer, hope I'm pronouncing that right, and then the Marker / Nicole would be our cast of characters. I'm not including the ones that are in the audio logs because they're not that critical.
Damn it. I wanted to say the engineer because the engineer said it like he had the most progression in the background.
Freaking Temple, yeah.
Yes, I love Temple because, like, you know he's not important at all. But you hear him go through all these adventures and whatever is ever going on with the Marker and everything that's going on through the story. And you just feel him just growing into this different thing that he's not.
Mm-hmm.
I love it.
That is really cool.
It would be interesting if in the remake they do change Isaac to be more like how Temple was in the autologs.
Maybe.
That'd be the potential.
Maybe they just change Isaac to Temple's story.
It wouldn't miss a beat. They're both engineers.
It's true.
They just have to change the motivation around and then you're pretty much good to go.
Mm-hmm.
So, most favorite character, Marley, we'll start with you. Which is your most favorite character?
I'm still gonna say it's fucking Temple. I don't care about your roster. Temple's my favorite character. Let's go.
Okay, I guess I'm gonna have to slap Rebel onto his freaking icon there.
What a Rebel.
Okay, so I guess Hunter, who is your favorite character then?
Like I said, I really like Kendra. Like, she, like, yeah, you could say, like, her sus at the beginning, like, towards Hammond.
Sus
was
at the
like,
beginning.
Like, you
bum,
gotta,
bum,
like,
bum, bum, bum.
Like, she was the one throwing fingers, and then that's what's, like, to be fair, like, I'm pretty sure she's the one that started all of it. Like, mm-hmm. She started throwing fingers at Hammond, and Hammond was retaliating. That's fair. She's on a mission to do a thing. That's fine. But, like, also, she kind of had the most sense more than Hammond.
Mm-hmm.
Even if she was in her own, like, and doing her own thing.
I gotcha. Yeah.
I like Isaac, but Kendra, man.
Yeah. So my favorite character is Captain Hammond.
Fair.
Okay, I was expecting to.
Hammond, you blithering idiot!
So my reasoning is that, one, he actually reverses a lot quicker on the whole getting the hell off of the Ishimura after the his communications came back. Maybe he would have said it sooner if Kendra wasn't deliberately trying to impede him. And if you saw it in the New Game Plus rewards, but we got, there's an audio text log that he gets. He did a background check on both Kendra and Isaac, so he perfectly knows who they're affiliated with. So no matter what, he's pretty much putting his trust as a leader in them, regardless. But yeah, that's about it. But
it's fair. I can't fault you for that.
Yeah, I mean, I wish he was more in the position of what Kynes was doing. It kind of just felt like he got replaced by him. But I guess it makes sense.
It's, I don't know. I feel like what Hammond was doing makes sense. It's just, I don't know. Hammond's a weird bag for me.
I gotcha. All right, then we're going to move on. Oh, sorry. Go ahead.
I was just going to say I kind of appreciate that Hammond is your favorite character, and then Hunter's is Kendra. I'm like, now I know how this happens if we have to play this game in 3-player mode.
What can I say? I guess I'm also kind of a sucker for a quiet villain character.
Yeah, you didn't see her betrayal coming.
Mm-mm. Like, it's just, like, she's, like, yeah, you look at this, we're introduced to the quote-unquote villain as, like, not the giant one-minded xenomorph, but this doctor who pushed his belief and made everyone, you know, like, killed a lot of people to make more necromorphs and shit like that. And then she's just over here like, no, I'm just doing government shit, and she just steals it.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I don't know.
Go ahead, sorry.
No, you're good.
I will come back to it. So, least favorite characters then. Marley, do you want to start, or Hunter?
Go ahead, Marley.
I'm trying to think. I'm not sure. I can't say I have a real least favorite character. But I would say in this instance, I mean, I understand it's an old game. Like, I'm going to put this there. I understand this. But I honestly would put Isaac as my least favorite.
Like, really?
Yeah. I mean, he's a silent protagonist. Yeah, that's pretty normal. But I feel like you should give him more than just the one moment that he really shines. And I know that this remake is probably going to be doing a lot more to actually shine on Isaac the character, given on how the game is completely expanded. Like, I'm just saying, if I was playing this blind in the year it came out, I don't think I would have been a real fan of him.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Hunter, who's your least favorite character?
I mean, mine's kind of obvious. Like, it's not Mercer. I can't ever remember the other guy's name.
Kynes?
Kynes. I didn't like, I get it. You're a crazy psychopathic doctor who has a hardcore religious belief, but for God's sake.
Wait.
Like, stop.
Isn't that just a contradiction, though? I mean, you would think, as a scientist, you would put science first over religion. Well, I guess maybe unless you are a scientist at a Christian university, or, you know.
I don't know, like it's one of those tropes that's done a lot, and I never like it in any sense.
Wait, hold on, is it Kynes or is it Mercer?
Kynes is the one that does the crazy shit, isn't it? Because Mercer is the one that, I don't know.
Kynes is the one that tells you to get the marker on the shuttle. Mercer is the one that keeps hounding you.
Because I don't remember, because their names are fucking confusing me.
They're very confusing.
Oh, yeah. Oh, no, which... Mercer, I'm sorry.
Okay, Mercer. Okay, I can agree with
that. I don't like the psychopathic doctor thing.
It's very overdone trope.
And, like, it's probably at the time it wasn't an overdone thing, but honestly, like, I didn't like it when it wasn't an overdone thing.
I like it when it's a little more, you know, refined. So I can agree with you on that. Like, maybe, like...
If he had more motive than, oh, this is our purpose, this is God's plan. No, no, it's not.
But what if maybe, like, you know, Dr. Frederick Frankenstein? Maybe something like that, where they kind of have that morality shift after they fucking did it.
I was just picturing Mercer being like, this is God's plan, and then God sitting in the corner like, bro, he's lying.
Bruh, why the fuck you lying?
Yeah, I totally agree with all that. So my least favorite character, and pretty much Hunter hit all the beats there, is the Chalice Mercer. Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like, just, come on. Yeah, it's very, there's nothing else like adding to him beside, oh, I'm evil and because God.
Like I said, I don't know. Like, I guess, like, that brings it back to what I'd like the comment I made earlier about if I understood, like, more of the reasoning of the marker being like it is, like, I don't think, I guess I could chalk it up to the mind, like, the one mind or whatever, like, influencing the doctor the same way Isaac was being influenced. But still, it doesn't make that much sense for me.
If he did say make us whole, maybe I would have believed it, but he didn't say it once, I think.
Yeah, like, that's all Nicole kept saying, so that makes sense.
Yeah.
I don't know. I think he was just a special flavor of crazy before. If I can quote, like, well, and I quote from Mass Effect 1, and literally the first thing you ever do, genius and madness are two sides of the same coin.
True. Okay, well then that brings us into a couple side mentions I have to make. So, there was something happening through this entire game, and I wonder if either of you noticed it. It deals with the chapters. Does anyone want to make a guess on that?
I think this is some extra far-fetched trivia that two plebeians might not be able to pick up on, so I'm going to say no.
Alright, fair enough.
I'm like, I have no clue.
So the first letter in the chapter spelled out something, and all 12 chapters spelled out Nicole is dead.
Oh, I've heard about that.
Yeah, no, I never would have picked that up.
No, I've heard, like, I knew that was a thing, because that was something, like, I was told about a long time ago, but no, I didn't notice it when we were playing.
It's fair enough. It's something that people really don't notice, but it's not even a detail they had to do, but they did anyways.
I mean, that's good game design.
It's true, but even then, we do have to mention that Nicole's supposed death is not a plot twist, and I don't know why some people act like it is, because they did not act like it was hidden very well.
No, like, it was obvious. Like, that wasn't her. Like, there's no way.
Yeah.
Absolutely no way. If she was alive there and a unitologist... That would have been probably a better twist, to be honest, if she was a little bit more crazy like that and Isaac accidentally kills her.
Yeah. I don't know, I guess the quote-unquote biggest twist was the Kendra reveal, and even then, I don't feel like this game had that hard of a twist in it.
The Kendra twist was probably better than the Nicole twist.
Because, like, yeah, like, you could kind of point out that she's being a little weird, and you could argue that she's probably more like the more suspicious target, but other than that, like her shooting the other doctor and then being like, "Yeah, I'm here for this, and I'm gonna leave you now." Like, all right, cool.
Yeah, I'm here for this.
I'm here for this marker, and I'm leaving, and you're dead. I'm like, oh, all right. That makes sense now that I think about it.
It's true. Okay, then that brings us into our subjective and objective scoring. If you don't know what that means, subjective means what you personally feel, and objective is, well, it's the facts. Spin facts. I know the kids. Anyway, so... So who wants to start with the we'll do based on you know, like out of 10 kind of things. Who wants to give their first subjective scoring on Dead Space 1? Do you guys want me to start on that? Give you a little bit more
time?
Okay.
I'll start. I'm going to give it... give it about 6.5 knee slaps out of 10.
Half knee slaps?
All right. can you give us a little bit on not the knees flap part, but why you give it 6.5?
Okay, if you watch Scott the Waz, you'd understand. I'm giving it a 6.5 out of 10 because you can clearly see it's not half-assed. Subjectively, I'm still reading this as an old game. So I can't really enjoy it to the full extent that I really want to. Like, I'm reminiscing in the past, but I also have to remind myself it's the past. Things aren't all that great about it. But it's still good enough for it to be, like, just there and, like, the average range. Like, I would enjoy it as, like, a one-time pickup for me. But I also know, like, other people are going to rate it a lot higher because it's someone's favorite game and played it 6 times. But you know.
Who could that be?
I don't know.
I don't know.
It's a mystery to us all. But I have to give it... I'm going to be a little bit higher. I do give it a 7 out of 10. I really think the game is, like you said, really solid. It's a good game. The story is pretty good. It's just it's lacking in the elements we've mentioned. I don't know if I would personally play this game, mainly because I'm not, one, a huge horror fan, on top of the fact I'm not a huge space fan, so it's not something I would have picked up.
Alright. Okay, so subjectively, I give it a 8 out of 10. I still love this game. It is a strong entry into the franchise. Very high replayability with the new game plus all the new weapons that you may not have tried. But storytelling wise, it's still got a few beats that still irk me. Like the military ship somehow defeated by one necromorph is a pretty big deal. In fact, in the background, there's the escape pods right there. And the Nicole twist is not very captivating. The Kendra stuff was a little bit better. And again, when you have Chalice Mercer running around telling you that you have to believe in the marker, I kind of roll my eyes a little bit. But yeah, that's just how I personally feel. Objectively, unless somebody wants to dip into that.
No dipping in on my end.
Okay. No sneeze slaps here. I can't believe it. Objectively, on the score, Hunter, I will start with you on that. Based on the story.
So based on story, I'd probably have to stick to about 7, 7 or 7.5.
Okay. Do you want to elaborate on that, or just kind of leave it at that?
I'm gonna kind of leave it at that because it's like I've expressed the way like I felt about this story.
Okay, fair enough. Marley, what's your objective scoring?
My objective scoring is probably gonna be a little higher than my subjective, because I will still admit that for the time it was released, I think it would have been a good story. So I'm going to pinpoint it around that 7 out of 10 range.
Okay.
So there you go. 7 solid knee slaps. Boom.
I'm going to surprise both of you here. Objective scoring for me is a 5 out of 10. It is.
Yeah.
It is just fine. It didn't have to go super hard, but it's a strong entry in the... You know what? Fuck it. 6 out of 10. It's a strong entry into the franchise. Again, it's a little bit of skipping beats here. It's not the best in the franchise. And we'll cross that bridge when we get there, but it's the whole gameplay thing, but we're focused on the storytelling, as I said, and it's good. It's just okay. It's not great. It could be better, but we'll see that in the remake if they ever really want to expand farther than this.
I hope they do, because like that, if they could just expand it just a little more, give Isaac a little more personality and screen time as a person, and not just an engineer who picked up his weapon, who picked up his gun, and thought it was a good idea to shoot it.
It is reasonable. He picks up the engineering tools that he's used to, but the pulse rifle—that's a military weapon, so I'm not sure how he knows that. And fucking the spinning thing, whatever.
I still think he was in the wrong profession.
Yeah. You could definitely make the argument that Isaac probably shouldn't survive the events of the Ishimura. But
I guess, like,
if he's using his tools...
Yeah, like, adrenaline's one hell of a drug, man. Like, that's... Like, I could believe that. Especially when he's trying to get to Nicole. Like, it makes sense. It's just, man, really, just go into the military after that shit. If you're not too fucked up, just go join the military. Like, somebody could use your skills somewhere.
That's true. Other than that, does anybody want to put in anything else that was not mentioned?
No. I think I pretty much got everything.
Yeah, if I'm talking serious here, yeah, I think we wrapped up pretty much everything in a nice little bow.
Yeah. So. That's usually what the denouement, I was about to say the wrong way.
Denouement! The denouements!
Denouement, sorry. So yeah, that's the whole thing, is just wrapping up the whole thing. That's the purpose of the name of this podcast, so... Yeah, so I can't tell you what we'll be working on next time. When we come across Dead Space 2, that'll probably be a little bit down the road. I mean, again, the Dead Space 1 story is pretty simple. I don't think we'll need to catch up on that. It's pretty simple. We'll get to Dead Space when we feel applicable. Maybe that'll be an October kind of release. Maybe do that in August. Pre-recording kind of thing. Other than that, we got a few thoughts in mind on what we can start with next. And when that happens, I gotta stop saying, when we get to that, we will see you next time. So thanks for watching. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye.
I should never have introduced you two to each other.
You're welcome.